Hi, I'm Alexander Vinyavsky. In these episodes, we talk about how to improve the security of solutions with cyber immune approach. We have already mentioned that in order to make the system more secure, it is better to consider security not as an additional requirement that should be attached to the system, but to implement it at the level of the system architecture. And one of the principles that should be followed here is the isolation principle. It means that we divide the system into separated security domains in accordance with the level of the trust in the code. But what exactly does this approach mean in terms of reducing cyber risks? Let's take an example of our recent digitalization project with a cable manufacturing plant. This is a sample of the final product of the plant, an underwater cable. With this cable, offshore platforms are supplied with electricity. Here you can see the cable has a lead shell. In our project, we were able to optimize the technological process of applying lead shell to the cable and as a result reduce lead consumption. To do this, we've implemented a digital solution in which, with the help of our Cyberimmune IoT gateway, data is collected directly from the lead shell application line and sent to the ERP system in real time. Such digitalization of the technological process usually not only gives a positive business effect, but also leads to accompanying critical cyber risks. In our project, thanks to the cyberimmune approach in general and isolation in particular, we managed to minimize cyber risks. To understand exactly how, let's look at the solution architecture and simulate a possible attack scenario. Let's imagine an attacker managed to hack some untrusted gateway component, say management console. For example, he organized a supply chain attack by implementing malicious code into this module at the stage of its development. What will happen in a regular IoT gateway? Since all components are in the same address space, it will be quite easy to develop the attack further and gain full control over the device. As a result, the attacker can do almost anything with it. For example, he can fake data and send incorrect parameters to the ERP system, or organize fraud scenarios, or encrypt information on machines and even stop the production line. Unacceptable business risks, right? And what will happen with isolation? In this case, all gateway components are literally separated from each other as if they are on different physical computers. That's why it will be extremely difficult to spread the attack on other gateway components. At the same time, hacking only one management console is not critical. It is not trusted, which means that the security goals set for the gateway will still be achieved even if it is hacked. So there will be no significant damage. Business users will have trusted data without the possibility for an attacker to access the physical infrastructure. Thus, we achieve needed business effect of digitalization without critical cyber risks. This is the value of cyberimmune approach and the isolation principle. Learn more about cyberimmune approach in our next episodes.